Sleep is your superpower. So we can understand how powerful sleep is for the body, let's talk about what happens when you don't get enough sleep. Let's start with you younger people. We've always known that we need sleep after learning to remember, to hit that save button on those memories. But recently, we also found out that we need sleep before learning. It's essentially the difference with a dry sponge ready to soak up all that information versus a soaked one that can barely absorb anything. In short, without sleep, the brain cannot absorb new data. The deficit of the brain's activity to make memories with and without sleep is 40%. And in case you're too sleep deprived to do the math, that's the difference between you acing an exam and failing it. And how about for the older people? A person that gets only 4 hours of sleep per night has the reproductive health of someone 10 years older. And that's for both males and females. As you age, sleep gets worse and your memory gets worse. That's not just co-occurring, but also significantly interrelated. They are now finding a link between lack of sleep and Alzheimer's. The silver lining is, unlike everything else in aging that we can't control, this is something that we can do something about. And that's just for the brain. Sleep is also as important for the body. Getting only 4 hours of sleep makes a 70% drop in killer cell activity. Those are the cells that fight off harmful invaders in the body. This leads to a concerning state of immune deficiency. This is also why sleep deficiency is linked to numerous forms of cancer. The link is so strong that the World Health Organization classifies any form of night shift work as a probable carcinogen because of the disruption of your sleep-wake rhythm. It's a fact. The shorter you sleep, the shorter your life. So here are some tips on getting some good sleep. Number 1. Regularity. Go to bed at the same time, wake up at the same time. Doesn't matter if it's a weekday or the weekend. Regularity is king, and it will anchor your sleep and improve its quantity and quality. Number 2. Avoid the damaging and harmful impact of alcohol and caffeine. Although alcohol may help you fall asleep, it's not the good kind of deep sleep. And as for caffeine, well, that's self-explanatory. Number 3. Keep it cool. Your body needs to drop its core temperature by about 2 degrees Fahrenheit to initiate sleep and to stay asleep. That's the reason it's easier to sleep in a room that's too cold rather than one that's too hot. And lastly, if you're struggling with sleep at night, avoid naps during the day. This way, when it's nighttime, your body is ready for bed. Sleep, unfortunately, is not an optional lifestyle luxury. Sleep is a non-negotiable biological necessity. It is your life support system. It's Mother Nature's best effort yet at immortality. And the decimation of sleep throughout industrialized nations is having a catastrophic impact in our health, our wellness, and even the safety and education of our children. It is a silent sleepless epidemic, and it is fast becoming one of the greatest public health challenges we face in the 21st century. It is time for us to reclaim our right to a full night of sleep, and without embarrassment or the unfortunate stigma of laziness. And in doing so, we can be reunited with the most powerful elixir of life, the Swiss Army knife of health, as it were. Sleep, our superpower.